Welcome back to my channel. I have recently purchased the iPhone SE 2020 model, and it's been around a month that I have been using it, and I thought now is a good time to share my views and my reviews for whether I like it or not. Just to give you a little bit of background, how I'm putting this video together, or what do I have in mind, or what am I referencing when it comes to the iPhone SE 2020. I have basically made this as a downgrade from iPhone X to iPhone SE 2020. And that's because, I was experiencing some issues with my iPhone X. It had been less than 2 years old and it had started having a lot of glitches. I mean, it wasn't the virus apparently, it was like a slight crack that I had on the screen that was just making any movement or any action impossible to do. It had been there for a long time, but I guess it's just started to take its toll on the phone now. So I would click somewhere and it would open a altogether different window or something like that. So it was just like my phone was having a mind of its own, and I could not work on it anymore. It was just becoming so much harder every day. So I thought that I will eventually have to buy a new phone. And to give you an idea of what I usually do with my phone, so you can gauge my usage and everything, I basically use it for filming, clicking pictures, mostly filming. I don't click those many pictures often, but yeah, I make my videos, I use it for editing my videos, I use it for social media primarily, and my office emails. So just basic, you know, those basic things. I'm not using my phone for any kind of gaming or anything which requires a lot of editing, you may call it. Editing might be something that takes a lot of effort, and you're doing a lot of motions altogether, but I would still feel that it is way less than gaming. So if you're watching this review and you're an avid gamer, you might not be able to get a lot of gaming insights per se, but definitely this video will be helpful in understanding the points and whether or not you should invest your money in SE 2020. So when I purchased it, I did a lot of research, and I really wanted to know the product before I buy it. Apple, I have been a loyalist for 4 years, but I still feel their products are extremely expensive. So my first iPhone was iPhone 6s, and I used it for a good 2.5 years or something, and then it was not usable anymore, so I had to upgrade it, and I upgraded it for iPhone X 64 gigs. So I brought it, but from the very first day I realized that I haven't been loving it at all. So I tried to adjust with it, I tried to play around with it, and although it was the OG phone in the market, I never felt it was the greatest phone there is ever. So when I was looking at a lot of reviews and a lot of research that I was doing for iPhone SE, majorly people were calling it not a great upgrade per se, because you're technically the screen size is reduced, you do not get that edge-to-edge experience that you would get from iPhone X or models above. It was definitely something which I feel is a preference, but sure, I'd like to cover all the things that I feel about the phone, so you're able to gauge and make an impression of it yourself. So a few very basic things about iPhone SE is that definitely going to be the screen size is 4.7 inches diagonally. The battery life is pretty okay. I'm not going to go into the specs because I was not learning them honestly, and I have not made notes on because you can easily find that information on the Apple website, so there's just no point repeating the same thing again and again. Processor, that was the highlight of this, that is why it's called an upgrade, is because it has an A13 Bionic processor, which is the same as I think iPhone 11. that has the same processor as this. Please don't quote me on this, but that is what I was pitched by the salesperson. The display is really good. It is Retina HD display, and the camera specs are: the front camera happens to be 7 megapixel and the rear camera happens to be 12 megapixel. So those are the basic details if you're interested. If you want to know more about them, definitely check the Apple website out, and they have very nicely laid out what all feature does it have and what are the other capabilities. So it is also splash, water and dust resistant, which is great because I'm like literally carrying my phone everywhere, and obviously India gets a lot of dust, and you know, since I have a baby in the house, it is very likely that my phone will come in contact with water like at least once in a day. So you know, those are all good things. Now talking about the pros and cons of what I experienced when I switched from iPhone X to iPhone SE. So the first major con is definitely going to be the screen size. Obviously, you become used to viewing your phone in edge to edge mode, where in iPhone SE the screen size is reduced and you see that bezel space, and it's kind of a waste in the real estate of the phone. So definitely that is a con that a lot of other like technical or seasoned reviewers have been talking about, and I experienced the same thing as well, that definitely the screen size is reduced. However, that being said, it's very easy to get used to this. You just have to play around with it a little bit, and then your eyes just become accustomed to it. So I won't say it was like a huge pain for me, because I'm not a gamer, as I said, and I'm able to get my things done with that screen size itself. So it's not a big, it's not a big down point for me per se. Battery life, it was said that definitely this has a slower, this model iPhone SE is comparable to the iPhone XR, and that has a longer battery life is what it is claimed, and then compared to this one. However, I haven't used XR, so I can't really tell you whether the battery life is better or not. I'm sure it is when they're claiming it, but with my iPhones, I've used 6s, X and this one as well. I think they, once you charge it to 100%, it takes like a lot of time for it to come down from 100, but once it starts dropping, it drops significantly. So it's not that in a blink of an eye I would see it's okay, it's 80%, and then automatically or suddenly it just gets to 30%. That doesn't happen. But of course, if you're like watching videos, if you're using your phone very often, I use it for a lot of online shopping, by the way. So if you're using your phone for like just keeping the phone flashlight on or working through it or seeing something on it, it is definitely going to drain faster. So I have honestly not seen any better battery performance compared to X and 6S. So it's not something that I'm like super conscious of, and again is like a huge con for me. It's working just fine. Then face recognition is gone. So face recognition is not available in iPhone SE. It has that finger touch experience again, and to be frank, I really loved it at the first hand. I always wanted that experience, because I kind of felt that the face recognition was did not always work for me, honestly. I mean, for iPhone X, I remember there were so many times that I would eventually have to enter the passcode only because it would just not take my face. So it's absolutely stupid, because a lot of times I'm like not even looking at it directly and it would still take my face, and then other times I'm like looking at it and I'm doing everything possible and it will still not unlock. So I thought it was a lot inconsistent. So I'm very happy that the touch point, the finger touch, is back with iPhone. To me, honestly, it's like traveling back in time. So definitely in terms of features, whatever you were using, if those of you using 6S, and upgrading to this, you won't feel, it'll be a seamless transition for you, of course. But if somebody is out there who has been using X and, you know, wants to I won't say it's an upgrade because technically it's not, but if they want to switch to the latest model because of the processor or any of the performance, they would definitely have a little bit of learning curve in the beginning, and eventually they will adjust to it and they will be okay, you know, sailing through it. But it is definitely a lot different. So those were the things that, you know, that would stand out to a lot of people, but to me, you know, they stuck with me. A lot of pros that I have listed here that I wanted to talk about is, one, the size. It is very compact, so it the size of it is same as 6S. So I honestly, for iPhones, I loved iPhone 5S the most because it was very handy, and, you know, it wasn't like you're carrying a lot of weight in your hand. But you know, eventually I bought 6S. I was not really a fan of the size, but, you know, nowadays I see all phones are at least that big, so, you know, I can't really complain. But definitely compared to X, the size is a little small. It works in my favor, especially because I have really tiny hands. So with X, it really felt like that I'm holding a lot of stuff, so I could barely hold anything else if I'm holding my phone in one hand, while this is a lot lighter, this is a lot smaller, so it gives me a lot of accessibility and I find it easy to carry and, you know, just a lot more easier to use also. And yeah, so that was my quick review. A lot of things that I have noticed hands-on, you know, which I'm going to talk about as hands-on experience, is that the camera quality, even though, you know, specs wise, I don't know, I mean, I'm not going to get in depth of that because I'm not a photographer or a professional you know, I don't do professional photography or anything. But something that I have absolutely did notice is, with iPhone X, whenever I used to click like a portrait picture or any picture, it exaggerated all the imperfection in my face so much, while this phone, you know, and it would exaggerate a lot of imperfections on my face while I could not see those things in person. So it was like honestly looking through yourself in a magnifying glass or something, because it would just make everything so much worse. Like, I had a little bit of pores going on, and if I have a little bit of acne spots, which were barely visible if you're like literally looking at me directly, it would still become so evident on the phone. So honestly, you know, hats off to the detailing, but I would prefer this camera over that, because of course this looks more real. This looks more close to what I look in person compared to iPhone X, where, you know, it'll take horrible pictures of me. And yeah, I mean, it might be a really silly point, but this is something that I have honestly noticed, that even if I'm not wearing any makeup, I'm just woken up or whatever, and I'm like clicking a picture, it would still look so nice. At least I would look like myself, while in that one, you know, I would go into a lot of complex looking at those pictures, that, oh my god, how do I mean, it looks horrible. So and outdoor photography, honestly, I haven't seen any difference between that iPhone X and this. In terms of natural light photography, I would definitely think this is way better compared to iPhone X. Video quality, in terms of like video calling, these days obviously a lot of us are doing video calls, and I do it on a daily basis to my family or friends or whoever, so they have also noticed that you know, my video is much more clearer, it's more crisper, and it definitely is a difference. There's definitely a difference between whatever was rendering in my video when I was using iPhone X compared to this. So camera wise, the video quality wise, I would definitely give it a full mark. However, now talking about the things that no one has ever talked about in any of the reviews I watched, at least, and they're like really weird things. So one of the things that I have noticed is, for a fact, that if I'm filming a video, one side of the phone would get heated up a lot while the other side would just be normal. I don't understand why that happens. It's not that I have kept it on a surface or it's taking heat from other devices around it. It just, you know, the top of the phone would be like, would get super hot while every, you know, while the rest of the phone is like normal. So that is one thing that I have definitely noticed, and I haven't seen anyone talk about it yet. So I'm not sure if it's just my phone or if it's something I'm doing that is causing, you know, this heating. But for sure, this is one thing I have experienced. Another really, really bizarre thing is this phone. I have a screen guard on it. So when I ordered the phone, I ordered the screen guard too. And, you know, when we put the screen guard on it, it took us 5 attempts and the screen guard would not, you know, would still have a little bit of bubble going around in the corners or somewhere or the other. So at first I thought it's because, you know, we're doing it at home, you know, otherwise in like normal scenarios we would have either gone to a shop to get it done. So you know, I lived with it, and then after 4 or 5 days we went to a store and we got the screen guard done, and that guy, the store guy, also had to waste like 3 of his screen guards to eventually find a screen guard that closely matches to this one. And the reason why I'm saying closely is because it still has that line going on and he could not get rid of it no matter how hard he tried. So he tried using like 3 other screen guards prior to this one, and he said, you know, this line is just not going away, so maybe you put it on charging and when the phone heats up, that's when that air or that bubble is gonna go away. But it didn't. In fact, when I'm using the phone, I realize that it is still kind of, you know, it's still coming out, the bubbles are still forming up on the corners of my phone. So that is really weird. That's something that I've never experienced with any of my iPhones before, and I'm not sure if there's like a little bit of curve on the screen or, you know, it's not leveled enough or whatever it is. But that is something really, really weird that I encountered while using this phone. So the bottom line for this phone is going to be, if you're somebody who films, if you're somebody who clicks pictures, it's a very great buy. It's affordable compared to other phones available in the market. If you're somebody who's buying their first iPhone, it's a great buy because it has everything that you know, that the highest model offers, especially the processor. So, you know, it's super fast, it's super amazing. But yeah, if you are someone who is who's an avid gamer, who's used to of the large screen on the phone, and you know, you're like using a lot of controls, I don't think you're gonna enjoy this phone as much, because of course it's compact, and if you are somebody who games a lot and you know, you're like constantly playing with your thumbs and fingers and everything, it will be very difficult for you now because the screen size is too small, and you know, it's just it won't be as easy for you to make that transition from a larger screen to smaller. The only reason why I'm okay with that is the fact that it's compact, I'm able to hold it in my hand easily, and you know, and that's why it's just easier for me. So I hope this was helpful for you. Let me know in your comments below what you think about this video, if there are other things that you have noticed and you're an iPhone user that I have not experienced yet. Maybe it is yet to come for me. So definitely comment down below. And I'm not a tech geek. I'm not somebody who's a lot into electronics or phones or whatever. So I'm sure this video lacks a lot of other technical aspects that you might be looking for. But I'm sure every information that you're looking for is available already on the Apple website. A few things which, you know, which I found what were nowhere to be seen in the research I did, I thought of covering those points. So hope this was helpful. Definitely like the video if you like the content, and do not forget to share, subscribe and follow me on Instagram too. Till then, stay home, stay safe.